There's a difference in allergy and coronavirus symptoms.
Allergies are more associated with itching. So they have like itchy nose, itchy and watery eyes. Allergy people do not have fever.
With a viral infection, you can get fever. A year ago, it was thought allergy medication with steroids could prevent the body from fighting off coronavirus. But now, LSU health allergist Dr. Sanjay Kamboj says people with environmental allergies should use nasal steroids. First, use nasal saline, then after a few minutes, the steroid spray. And when it comes to nasal steroid sprays, infectious disease specialist Dr. Brobson Lutz noticed something in his patients who use them.
I've been amazed by the number of my asthma and bad COPD patients, Meg, who have not had major COVID complications.
So Dr. Lutz has all of his patients, not just those with asthma, on Flonase, one puff two times a day as a preventive, not after they catch COVID.
The nasal steroids seem to keep those serious symptoms away, and people are more likely to have asymptomatic or very mildly symptomatic COVID disease if they have been on long-term generic Flonase.
It lowers inflammation in the nose and sinuses. It's not FDA approved for this, but allergist Dr. David Schneider sent us this study on budesonide, an inhaled, not nasal, steroid that prevents inflammation in the lungs. It suggests using it early when infected reduced COVID patients' need for urgent medical care, and they got well faster. With Flonase, Dr. Lutz says it will not stop an infection.
But if you can find a preventive technique that has a little theory behind it, that is cheap and is safe, I'm all for it.
Meg Farris, Eyewitness News.
And since nasal spray is not studied and approved for COVID prevention, always check with your doctor first before using it.